and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Chicago Cubs franchise mode series, making its debut in the new game, MLB The Show 16, first episode here in the new game. I've been kind of waiting to see what I wanted to do with franchise mode. I'm going to be starting a new franchise. That is going to be an undetermined team to this point, but it's going to happen when the Operation Sports full rosters come out. I believe that's 80 or 90% done at this point, the last update we got. Interesting, I go into my pitching rotation and I see somebody I don't recognize, and he's actually the starter today. His name is Falk. I don't remember having a guy named Falk in my pitching rotation, but after looking at that opening menu there, I see I traded Brett Anderson away. I was thinking maybe Brett Anderson got renamed, but no. I think he was a part of the Byron Buxton trade because he's now on the Twins roster. Makes sense. I'm just kind of catching up to the dealings that I had going into this game, and Byron Buxton striking out against what is his team in real life. But Starlin Castro coming up, and he's going to hit this ball well. Left center field, and it is a ground rule double. All right, starting off the offense in the first inning for the Cubs. Castro going ahead and getting himself a double right off the bat against Alex Meyer here and the Twins. So last year when we ported the Cubs franchise from 14 to 15, we lost Ryan Madsen as our closer. I mean, he's still there, but he was renamed Michael Perez or something Perez. As our closer, and I'm like, wait, what happened? You see a base hit right here by Pete Chavez, DHing today because we're in an American League park, and he's driving home Starlin Castro with the first run of the game. Good for the youngster getting into the lineup and producing. Now it's Anthony Rizzo coming up, and that's down the right field line. Going to be played off the fence, and Rizzo is going to have himself a double. Yes, he is just in ahead of the tag. That was a close play. As they got that in quickly on the relay, almost got him at second base, but Rizzo's got the double, and the Cubs already up 1-0, are poised to maybe get more. So I was starting to explain what happened with Ryan Madsen, how he dropped off the roster, probably because he wasn't on the MLB Players Association anymore, whatever, couldn't be in the game. Well, we have the same situation this year. We lost Torii Hunter. He retired. And he was renamed on our roster set as well. I'm like, who is this guy that was supposed to be DHing? When I finally put two and two together and figured out that must be the Torii Hunter placeholder. You see a walk right there by Falk, and now he's got to face Joe Mauer, and that's a good eye by Mauer right there. Always been known for that. He takes the walk, and two guys on, but here you go. He comes back with a strikeout, so Michael Falk able to get the second out, and that pitch to Arcia is inside as well. So he's now walked the bases loaded. That's not good. That's not good at all. But he still has a chance to get out of this. One and two, two outs. Pop up by the dugout. Catcher going over. Does he have room? He does, and the inning is over. They escape a jam. Walk the bases loaded, but then get on out of there with no hits allowed. Cubs continue to lead 1-0. Charlie Blackmon at the plate, and I've talked time and time again about how much I like using Charlie Blackmon in my franchises, in my Diamond Dynasty, whenever I have him. He just makes great contact to all fields, and he shows it there again, pulling this pitch down the right field line and getting himself a double. You see he's on that doubles leaders list, but he's not at the top as of yet. Got a ways to go to do that. Here is a base hit down the left field line. That should be extra bases. It plates. No, he's going to stay at first. He's going to stay at first. Okay. Not much speed there, and it shows, but it is an RBI single, and it's 2-0 Cubs. Now with runners at first and second, and Castro misses, but the pitch gets away. And the throw down to third gets him. Well, that's why he wasn't going anywhere on that previous play where he might have had a double. Yeah, we see now the lack of speed. And it's 2-0 as the inning ends. So out to the mound is Falk again. This is a pop-up to first base. Looks like no problem. And he's going to have it. Inning over as Rizzo squeezes it. And the Cubs will once again grab their bats. So doing this video and this commentary right here reminds me the fact that I was actually at Target Field yesterday watching the now 0-9 Minnesota Twins drop yet another game. It is the worst start in franchise history. They've never started, I think, once they reached 0-7, it was the worst. This ball deep for Joe Mauer, though, who takes it deep and gone to right field. Mauer does not hit for much power these days, but he does it right here. shows more power in this game than he does in real life, to be honest. He used to hit him the opposite field in the Metrodome a lot. That left field line, he'd take him the opposite way, and he'd hit a lot of them there. But it's a little deeper, and the park plays a little different here at Target Field. His home run production has really been cut down since the team moved here. Anyway, he hits this one out 382 feet. And coincidentally, it's Joe Mauer who's really the only one doing anything average-wise or even looking like a major league hitter at this point for the Twins' real-life roster, that 0-9 debacle they got going on. So it was very nice to get back to Target Field yesterday as Charlie Blackmon hits this deep and gone. And talking about getting home runs out of this park, that is not an easy part of the park to hit a home run to. But Charlie Blackmon does it, and he continues to be an awesome hitter. I'm telling you, Junk's got him on his Colorado Rockies franchise that he started up this year that's had a couple episodes. He hits well on that. He hits well here for my Cubs. You know, I've known that from last year. He's just a great guy to have on the roster. But there is strike three as the Cubs are getting out of an inning there. They end the fourth inning up 3-1 now. With a runner on second base and a swing by Javier Baez deep to center field and gone off the base of the batter's eye right there. Little new center field configuration. Nothing new with the park dimensions. The wall's still the same as it ever was, but they redid, pulled out some seats out in center field and made a new luxury seating spot there called Catch. You see the limestone out there that matches other parts of the ballpark. That two-tiered thing there, at least the bottom tier of that is called Catch. They have computer screens there for people to check out replays and stats and all that stuff. And this ball is hit deep and off the wall in right center field. The Cubbies starting to pour it on right now. Another run is home. I believe that's Chris Bryant crossing the plate. And Charlie Blackmon has struck again. Holy smokes. He's having himself a day. So, yeah, back to that Catch seating out in center field. I'm anxious to try it out maybe once. It's a spot where you have to commit to a season ticket. They don't sell single game tickets there. But obviously you can buy them on the secondary market like on StubHub. So I'll probably check it out there someday. I think the food and drinks are complimentary out there too. Joe Mauer just misses his second homer of the game. If that's a couple feet to the right, it catches the overhang and is gone. Instead, tough luck for him as it's caught. 6-1 right now as Oswaldo Arcia strikes out swinging. He will do a lot of that today, you will find out. So it's 6-1 after six innings as Falk is getting it done. And speaking of getting it done, Chris Bryant, three-run shot to left. It's gone. And that will pretty much bury the Twins on this day. It would have been nice if they showed up. Now, I forgot to mention it, but I think earlier on, just signs that the Twins aren't even trying in this. They have Kurt Suzuki playing center field in this game. You might have noticed that on the ground rule double early on. I forgot to say anything about it. I knew I was going to mention it. You see Chris Bryant able to take this one to left and victimize Twins pitching even further. But yeah, they got Kurt Suzuki playing center field, which makes no sense. I mean, if you're going to bury him out in right, I get it. But center field, really? Look at this ball. Jorge Soler reaches the third deck. They are just teeing off on the Twins right now. This is not good. The starter didn't do well. Alex Meyer, the bullpen, definitely not doing well right now. Serving up a pitch right down the middle to Jorge Soler. And yeah, third deck. My goodness, what a shot. 11-1 Cubs. But the Twins, you know what? They're like, nah, we're not quite done here. We're not going to roll over. There's a RBI single. Going to make it 11-2. And maybe Falk is running out of gas here. He's at 103 pitches, and that's wide. That's going to load the bases, actually. And I think it may be time for the Cubs to go to the bullpen. They're going to talk this over, and that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to call for Pedro Strop, who's been warming up, to get on onto the mound and see what he can do. So he's got a 3-2 count with one out. Bases loaded, and that's wide. Not even close. Danny Santana draws a walk that forces in a run. It's now 11-3. Okay, you don't want to be giving away free runs, but that's what's happening right now. Joe Mauer at the plate, and he takes a ball. Oh, man, that one, he kind of got squeezed on that call. That could have been a strike. Instead, it's ball four. It's 11-4. All right, we got to get an out here. Just get things going. Oh, double play ball. This can get us out of the inning. Bryant to no, he dropped it. They're going to say out at second, but the inning continues because he could not turn that double play. Now, the Twins are going to argue that that was never even an out at second base, but he says no, he lost it in the transfer. So two outs, runners at the corners. That pitch is wild pitch, almost hits him, and the run comes home to score on the head first slide. Why is the pitcher not covering home plate there? That's a big gaffe. I don't know that they would have gotten him had he did, but at least they would have had a shot. As Strope just stands there, I don't know, maybe he thought he hit him or something. That ball comes right back to the catcher. But, I mean, he can't run and tag him. You need to make a throw to the plate there. So that's it for Pedro Strope. We're going to call on Jake McGee, and this needs to end right here. It's 11-6. Two runners on, and he does get a strikeout. Finally, this inning's over. I was getting very uncomfortable for the Cubs as their large lead was starting to evaporate in front of their eyes right there. So Anthony Rizzo up, and he's going to strike out. Can't catch up with that fastball. Inning is over. Cubs don't tack any more onto their already impressive 11-run total. Kurt Suzuki, your center fielder, I still can't get over that, is going to hit the ball to right. And whoa, what happened? Charlie Blackman, no. That ball bounds away into the corner. And you see him scrambling here. He was about ready to get back to the bag instead. He got second and third. And what happened to Charlie Blackman out here? If you watch this replay, Junk and I were chuckling about this one. It hits him right in the head, I think. I think it hit him right on the head. He's lucky he wasn't injured. But now you've got one out, two runners on, and a fly ball to center field. This should be a sacrifice fly, as it's definitely deep enough. Makes the catch here, and the throw comes in. That should have gone to the cutoff. You see the runner taking an extra base. Not real smart right there. But, yeah, it's now 11-7 with a chance for more. With two outs and a 3-2 count, Jake McGee going to get the ground ball the second. Can we get this to just go cleanly? Yes. Okay. So the inning is over. Twins get one more, but they still are down by four. That's important to get that run, though, because a grand slam now could tie this up. You know, you always want to get to grand slam territory. Well, they got two on, and they got Trevor Plouffe up, and Plouffe is going to hit this to right field, and it's right at him, and he makes the catch. It's not off his head this time. Game is over. The Cubs win it. Kind of a crazy one. They take it here at Target Field 11-7, and just as in real life, the Twins just keep on losing ball games. Poor Twins. Anyway, the Cubs win, and so now there's something that we got to just talk about here. I want to throw up a poll and get your guys' thoughts on this. Do we continue the Cubs franchise going into its third game now, 14, 15, and now MLB 16? Do we continue it as an edited series as you're seeing today? Or do you want this to move over to a live stream only where, I don't know, maybe we just kind of have fun live streaming it? You guys vote on that. There will be a franchise coming up with a new team as soon as the Operation Sports rosters are out. Okay, vote, and we will see you next time. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.